of the system that we inhabit. And with the psychology of growth and consumption, a psychology that continues to create the ongoing social and environmental destruction that we see, abuse and exploitation all around us, that so many environmentalists complain about, but yet they still tend to not realize that the system is based on that. It's defined by consumption. It's defined by turnover. And we often think that corporations should be held responsible for their actions because of their abuse of this nature, when in fact the competitive market model of economics demands that behavior. Again, it's structural. You know, how is it in a world that's supposed to be economizing? What is the definition of an economy? It means the management of a household. What does that mean? It implies that you have to be thrift. It means you economize. It means you save. It means you're strategic in what you do. How is an economy based on consumption to maintain your employment, economize it all? Obviously, it's a complete anti-economy. It's time we consider amongst all of this that the problems that we're seeing, that all of us are here about, are actually systemically rooted in the core structure of what defines our economic system and the psychology that is created, supported, and rewarded. I keep hearing the phrase in the Occupy movement, we are the 99%. And while I understand and admire that communicative gesture, I would like to expand back and think about this a little bit more technically. I think it's a little more accurate to say we're not the 99%. We're actually the 100%. And all of us are to blame. The only reason the 1% have what they do is because the 99% have been supported by... The only reason the 1% have what they do is because the 99% continues to support all the elements that fuel the wealth of the 1%. The system is literally designed to support the 1% over the 99%. The values that we see in our culture are designed to make sure you aspire to those that maintain the role of the 1%. It's called the American Dream, remember? The American Dream, which only exists for the 1%. It always did. You know, the success of us is often measured in our material wealth, or how we gain admiration in the culture, our dignity defined by what others think of us. Is that true success? No, that is a false, distorted value that came from a system that needed to be based on everyone being inquisitive, competitive, cutthroat, and essentially inhumane.
Yeah.
The historical illusion, I have to point out, which continues to this day, which I know is manifest in a lot of gestures here in this audience and across the world, rightfully so, however, but it's still illusion, is that there is some person or some group that is explicitly to blame. Rather than focus on the fact that 1% of the world's population has over 40% of the planet's wealth, let's instead ask ourselves the question, how is that even possible? How is that even possible that our system allows for such a thing? Do we really have grounds to be surprised at the way the world is operating, when the very foundation of what motivates the current social order is taken into account? Should we really be surprised at all? What is the economy? I ask the question. The monetary market model of work in the world means that through the movement of money, power and property can be bought and sold at will within the confines of, say, legal legislation. Legal legislation, by the way, which, yes, is for sale in the open market. Just as all politicians are for sale in the open market. Just as all administrations' policies in general are for sale in the open market, what did you expect when the whole system is based upon the buying and selling of property and power and hence influence? There is no escape from the influence of money with respect to governmental policy. Why? Because government in this system is nothing more than a business. That's all it can be. And I hope that can become clear in the minds of many. And see, the true root of change has to be beyond the lobbying for government to do things within our favor. It has to go deeper.